Bill Goudy checking in. I'm in Missouri. I'm down near Sullivan, Missouri at Meramac Campground. Got a nice fishing hole right here in the spot right behind me. Yes, sir. I'm gonna give it a little try. See if there's any fish in this lake. Just awesome day. A little breezy, but not bad. Not bad at all. If you're ever in the Sullivan, Missouri area, you better check out this campground. I'm telling you, it is nice. You got full hookups, they got some partial hookups, and they got primitive camping. It's all here. Yes, it is. All right. Let's see if we can catch a fish. Shall we? So, I'm not sure what the bass length is, or the catfish got to be 13 inches, I guess. That's what that is. Catfish are 13 inches, and the bass must be 15 inches. Look real close right here. 15. They have a measuring stick, I believe, is what that's supposed to be. Bass are 15. Bluegills, there is no size or amount, so, and there's no fishing with minnows, which I'm not anyway. But it's always important to know what each site has for limits and size. There's one. Not bad. Not too bad. See that? Yeah, good size bluegill. So I've caught some bluegill, and now I'm going to get some firewood and some kindling. Yep. We're gonna cook some bluegills the old-fashioned way. So, I've caught my supper. Yep, I caught 6 fish, and that's all I need. I just need 6. And I'm gonna cook them the old-fashioned way in the cast iron skillet over the campfire. Yeah, Grandpa would be proud. And you know, it's just a good way to do it. I think a tossed salad and, let me turn this radio down a little bit. There we go. All right, so I think Grandpa would be proud of the way he taught me. So I didn't have my stringer, and you know, I've been fishing out of the boat, but I'm gonna correct that problem, I'll tell you that, next time on my next outing. But yeah, I used a bush container. Yep, I got the bush container. The fish were inside there. I just, I caught 6 in a quick hurry. I'm gonna scale them and cut their heads off, and we'll cook them in the, put them in the, oh yeah, I gotta show you this. So I'm gonna cook them in almond flour and coconut flour blend. Yeah, that's one of my favorites. In a cast iron skillet, in my cast iron skillet from Chicago Foundry, I do believe. It's not marked, but the people that are in the know have told me that. So I'm going to set this camera up on a tripod and show you just real quick how I scale the fish and prepare them for this. Just that easy. That's just how easy it is. Pull those scales right off there. So if you hear a little noise in the background, you can see some people out there. Yeah, they're having some fun. No, I don't blame them. A paddle boat then a kayak. Looks like fun to me. So I had a viewer tell me that he scores his fish when he cooks them like this. And I do my catfish. I score my catfish, but I've never scored a bluegill. I'm going to try it just because it was a suggestion. And I cannot remember for the life of me. But I'll put a link if I can find it. I will put a link to his channel down below. So when I do my catfish, I do it about a quarter to a half inch. And I just score them. I just cut the skin and let the flour get down into there, into those little cuts. And it makes it cook a little faster this way. And you know it's done. So now I have all the bluegills scored or cut right just to the backbone. And now we'll dip them in the flour. We'll get the fire ready and then we'll get the cooking, shall we? This is you can use the oil of your choice. This happens to be just vegetable oil. Pouring into that pan. And I'm gonna put about a quarter to a half inch of oil in there. And I'm gonna add about a quarter stick of butter, real butter. Anytime you have oil over an open fire, you have to be careful. Yeah, that's my word of warning for today. But that butter makes that oil settle down and gives it good flavor. So I'm putting the bluegill one by one in the coconut flour, almond meal, the coconut flour and the almond flour blend. And of course you can put other spices in there. And we'll coat the fish properly. We just work that flour all around it. Looks just like that. Looks beautiful. I wish you could smell that. It's got a nutty campfire smell. Yeah, smells like nuts. Must be the almond flour. It smells good. Man, that smells good. Ah, it's looking good. Man, does that smell good. I must be hungry. Look at that, will you? Well, you just look at that. Wow, within the hour, yeah, they were swimming Yeah, they were swimming right out there. Yeah, I caught them right there at that snag. Yeah, right here, right now. It doesn't get any fresher, I guarantee it. You can't buy this. Well, you can't buy it anywhere that I know of. Yeah, this is Kenny DeMarco's. Yeah, whipping cream and blueberry. And blueberry jello and real blueberries in there. So I'm getting a little bit of complex carbs out of that. Oh yeah, I'm gonna lick that real quick. Yeah, that's a tossed salad. Yeah, and my favorite, chunky blue cheese dressing, and there's no sugar in that. And that's what I like about that. I know there's a lot of people out there don't like that blue cheese, but I sure do, and I like it because it has no sugar. So I can tolerate it. Yeah, well, but you know what else I have to tolerate? Bad boy buggies. Yeah, well, it's what's inside. Yeah, an ice cold bottle. Yep, ice cold bottle of Busch beer. 10 calories. Yeah, 10, I'm sorry, 10 carbs. It has more calories. I'm not counting the calories. Got that bad boy buggy from Gun Wild One. Yep, link for this channel will be down below. Tell him Bill Goudy sent you. Let's dig in, shall we? Man, oh man, this looks good. This looks so good. Oh, look at that. Yep, little Kenny DeMarco dessert. Yeah, look at that, peel right off. Look at that right there, huh? Can we look at that? Man, oh man, that is good. Yeah, and it has a good flavor. Man, oh man, that's good. I must be hungry, man. Yeah, I'm gonna have some tossed salad here with this, just to show it to you. Some of that dessert. I just made it. I did put it in the freezer, but it didn't get a time. It didn't get time to freeze solid yet. But it is good and it is cold. Oh wow! I am telling you, that is so good. Got to wash it down with a quality product. Yep, I got that in St. Louis. Yep, St. Louis, STL Ray Edwards. Yep, I got that over there at his house. Oh man, better try that again. Wow. I'd like to stay and talk to you a little longer. You know, that's nice. The scoring is nice, but I don't think it's required. I score the catfish because they're bigger. You know, I don't know that it's required on the bluegill because they're not as thick. But they're good. And you get a little more coating in there, I suppose. It's really good. Anyway, I'd like to stay and talk to you a little longer, but you know how it is. I gotta go. I appreciate everything you guys do. I appreciate all the comments. I appreciate the subscriptions. It is just awesome. This YouTube is just an awesome place. Missouri is an awesome place too. I got a lot of subscribers from Missouri. Believe it or not. All right. Bill Goudy out. Really out this time.